Hello there, I'm Roland Schumann, the gardener here at Growing Spaces. In this video, we are going to talk about seed starting in hopes of helping you have fast, consistent germination rates. By understanding the fundamentals of what seeds are and why they sprout when they do, we can better design situations and practices that enable successful starts for our garden. If we are starting seeds ahead of when we are ready to plant them in our gardens, we can fit more mature plants into limited spaces over the course of the season and get a head start on our outdoor plants while temperatures are still too cold. To begin, let's talk about seeds. A seed is an embryonic plant enclosed in a protective covering, often with a small supply of nutrients to feed the plant in its initial stages of growth. The plant is alive inside the seed, but its growth is on hold, and its metabolism is slowed to a crawl. For a seed to wake back up, or germinate, its metabolism must be reactivated by the right environmental conditions. Externally, this means the proper range of temperature, moisture, air, and sometimes light or darkness, or even the presence or absence of particular chemicals. What each particular species and variety needs is closely tied to its natural habitat. Perhaps this inspires a question: why do seeds exist? Seeds are a means for plants to propagate themselves, and one that has been highly successful. This is because reproducing in this way, the plant may remain dormant through conditions unfavorable to its growth, like a cold winter or period of drought. Also, seeds allow for plants to be dispersed over a region to a variety of microclimates and situations. This is sort of a way that a plant can hedge its bets for the next generation. Seeds should ideally be stored in cool, dry, dark locations to keep them inactive and viable. Know that some seeds remain viable for years longer than others, so looking up the particular type of seed's shelf life could help determine how heavily you should sow older seeds and what to expect as far as their germination. So now we want to get our plants moving towards becoming seedlings. How do we wake them up? For most seeds we start, we can simply place them in the right combination of moisture and air within the right temperature range. Personally, I like to start most seeds in the medium I want them to root in, thus reducing the handling of them at their most fragile state. Here's a basic example of what this can look like. I'm going to plant these tomato seeds in a sterile, dampened mix containing primarily coconut coir and perlite. I like this mix because it provides a nice balance of both air and moisture, and because coconut coir is more likely to be sustainably collected from waste coconut husks than peat mosses from bogs. These tomato seeds will do well planted at about an eighth of an inch deep. After we water these in, we'll cover them under either a plastic bag, plastic cover, piece of glass, something like that, that'll trap the moisture and also keep the heat high over the course of the few days it takes for them to germinate. These will likely take 7 to 10 days to germinate. In early spring, or when there's not enough room in the greenhouse, I like to start seeds indoors under a fluorescent or LED bulb. This allows me to check on them regularly to make sure that they haven't dried out, and also to remove the covering as soon as they have sprouted. Let's take these and place them under our plastic cover. I prefer an elevated plastic cover so that if the seeds take varying amounts of time to germinate, they have enough room to grow without pressing up against the cover, trapping too much moisture and making them more susceptible to disease. The growing dome provides a stable and warm place to start seeds this time of year. So I'm going to take my tray and place it somewhere not too close to a vent or door, but somewhere on top of a thermal mass that will radiate heat out throughout the night, thus keeping the temperature within the range I want to get these seeds on their way. These tomatoes will likely take between 7 to 10 days to germinate. They like a range between 70 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit for ideal germination, but outside of that is okay, but below 50 degrees or above 95 degrees is really going to hurt the percentage of them that comes up. Once most of these seeds have germinated and begun to sprout, I'm going to remove the top to reduce the likelihood of moisture-aided diseases and molds affecting the tender seedlings. Now this method will work for many varieties of plants. The moisture and temperature will allow the hard covering of the seeds to soften and crack where moisture and gases can penetrate inside. However, with some seeds, scratching the surface or even making cracks in the surface of the seed, a process called scarification, will greatly help the penetration of moisture and gas. In others, a cold and moist period called stratification is required before germination can begin. you could place them in a damp paper towel in the fridge for a couple days to a couple weeks, depending on the variety, before planting them in soil and moving them to a warm place. And for others, processes can include leaching of natural chemical growth inhibitors from a seed, or placing them in very high temperatures for some plants native to areas where forest fires are common. But these are far less likely to be necessary for common plants. The point is, it helps to know the sort of environmental recipe for starting the specific plant you have selected. And this information is usually readily available online. The growing dome has a much longer season than outdoors, pretty much all year long. So I like to start seeds regularly to always have plants ready to fill in the spots after something is harvested. I hope this has helped you better understand your seeds so you can have consistent success germinating for your garden. From the Growing Spaces Growing Domes, happy planting.